With us now for more, live from London is Chris Nelson, president of the British Chamber of Commerce of Philippines. Good to see you again, Chris. Welcome to the program.
Yes, thank you again, Kathy, and good afternoon to everybody there.
Yes, it's still morning. It's at about 10:30 Manila time. What do foreign investors make of the now signed anti-terror bill? What did it deter the current and prospective British investors to locate or do business in the Philippines?
So we recognize it's a very important issue. Based on discussions, however, with companies here, what they're looking at specifically is how is the economy opening up? Specifically, can they be moving to a more modified community quarantine in Metro Manila, as mentioned by Secretary Dominguez in an interview? Also, very importantly, is the stimulus. That's very important to them. What is the activity going on to support the economy? And those, I think, are those are three key, those are the key areas for the companies. The other one, actually, is for people able to visit the Philippines. We have certain businessmen who'd like to visit, but as we understand currently, that's restricted. And those are the areas that they're focusing on because they want to see the economy. They still have a great interest there, but obviously those are the key points. Further opening up of the economy, stimulus is particularly important, and of course the ability to visit.
On the surface, Chris, do you think it's going to be a concern for the British investors in the Philippines?
As again, I said, we recognize a very important issue, but again, based on our discussions, what the investors here and British companies are looking at are in specifics in terms of economic support. Obviously, they've seen economies opening up here in the UK. As you saw, there was a further opening up as of last on the 4th of July. And they'd like to see that activity also in the Philippines and how the economy will progress and obviously grow again, obviously offsetting the impact of the pandemic.
On another note, I know that you and I have talked about you flying back to Manila last week, but you're still in London. Was it a challenge still to get a flight back?
No, there was some logistical change, and it meant I had to go somewhere else first. So therefore, we decided as a family we wouldn't do that at this particular juncture. We're obviously hopeful still to return soon. However, also looking, we have something to do in Europe. But I think specifically, we are still looking to go back. And again, I think it's also I would like to go back, obviously, and see because obviously it's like my home and my commitment. So it's just a logistical matter at the moment, but hopefully that will be solved and I'll be back in the Philippines relatively soon.
So you've decided to stay there a couple more weeks and just coming off a weekend there in London, I gather that the restaurants, the pubs and cafes there have been allowed to open after safety guidelines. So what was it like?
Well, it was like, well, I think first of all, a few things. Number one, they opened up hairdressers. So you might see, or your viewers may notice, I'm actually somewhat better groomed. So my apologies for previous times. Also, they've opened up churches. So I was able to attend a physical mass. And I understand also there's going to be dry runs in the Philippines. Again, very strict protocols. And again, we went in the evening, I went out to a bar restaurant. And again, there was observation of protocols, but people were very happy to see it. And I just like to emphasize a couple of points, if I may, because I think this relates also to the Philippines. Our chancellor here had a slogan, which was eat out to help out, because the hospitality business here employs, I think, an estimated 3 million people. Similarly, in the Philippines, we obviously have a lot of engagements with the Secretary of Trade and Investment. And there again, we're also encouraging people where they can, but observing all the protocols to actually go out because that's what the economy needs. It needs activity. So it was a successful Saturday in the UK. Based on the observation of the police, people broadly kept to it and they thanked the public for that commitment. And again, they're only looking at wherever necessary to do only very specific localized lockdowns or restrictions. So a successful start, and obviously we look forward to similar successes from our members working in the Philippines.
How's it going? I mean, in your conversations with your chamber members here, a similar situation happening in Metro Manila, more restaurants resuming dine-in services, critical to the survival of most, if not all, in the industry.
Yeah, it is actually. So if you notice, we've done a whole series of webinars. We've obviously had Secretary Lopez before, and he's obviously hoping, assuming things progress, they can move to, or hoping that we can move to, a modified general community quarantine, which allows more capacity for restaurants. Similarly, that was quoted by Secretary Dominguez. And also we had a webinar with Secretary Romulo Puat of tourism. And that's another key, because tourism is actually a very important factor in the Philippines. And I think it's actually employing a very high number of workers. I think she said 5 million related. Our members are getting involved. Of course, they'd like to see a higher capacity. Everybody understands fully the health protocols and keeping to that. At the same time, encouraging people, you know, observe the protocols, manage the risk, but let's get out there. It's, as it's been said, yes, we fully understand the virus is here, and we have to respect that, and we have to respect health protocols, but we also need to keep moving the economy going forward. And that's the clear message from our members. And again, I'd like to just stress and hope that Congress, I believe there's a discussion to have a special session to discuss the stimulus bill, because we also had a webinar with Congresswoman Sharon Guerin, who is very eloquent on it. And we really want to see that as much as can be pushed forward, because that's what they're looking to do. More capacity, more opening up, and more support.
So what do British investors think of how more and more businesses are being allowed to restart, but at the same time, we're seeing the infection curve continue to rise? I mean, the Philippines reported a record 2,434 new confirmed cases.
Yeah, and that's, to be honest, I look at what is being said, and again, let's look at a parallel with places in Europe and here in the UK. For example, here in the UK, although everywhere opened up in England, may I stress, it's different for England, South Wales, Scotland, and Northern Ireland. There was a particular city called Leicester where there had been also an increase in infections, and there was a localized lockdown. And I think that's the other part. I mean, obviously, we appreciate that as the economy opens up, there is obviously the risk, as you've correctly noted, Kathy. At the same time, and as noted by, actually, I think it was even Secretary Dominguez, again, referring back to his interview, I think it was the Manila Times, basically saying, look, we should be focusing on localized lockdowns, localized barangays. And that's an example that's going on here in England, and it's also going on in Europe. So I think the question, as I come back to, and the message is, we've got to move forward with the economy. We've got to give, obviously, full respect to the health protocols, and where we can do, be very focused efforts, i.e. either localized barangays or localized areas, even buildings. I mean, that's happening now, of course, in Australia, where they're localized a specific power block. So I think people have recognized overall lockdowns have a very obviously severe impact on the economy, and therefore the aim is, how can we move forward while managing risk and being very respectful?
And the webinars and e-training, you made a mention of it earlier. To your point, you've made a priority for tourism and digitization. What do you intend to achieve going forward, and how do you keep that conversation going as we go through the differing levels of the lockdown and into the new normal?
Well, I think, first of all, I mean, I'd like to say about our webinars in the chamber, we work in cooperation with all the other European chambers, and we've also cooperated with many chambers. And I want to just emphasize that point, because I think what this pandemic has really reinforced everywhere is team effort and teamwork. So what we're anticipating is, A, how can we continue to communicate the views of our members? And I'd like to thank all the over 300 companies that are members of the British Chamber. How can we communicate that to officials? How can we have an ongoing dialogue? And I'd like to thank everybody who's been on our webinar, because there's ongoing questions, and how we can work together and really get the economy moving. And the other thing, which I think is a very critical point based on our discussions in these webinars, is employment. As we noted in our last interview, and I hope I'm going to get it right this time, It's 17.7% was the unemployment figure then quoted. And obviously that's a high concern, and we appreciate action taken. For example, I think 2 weeks ago, Banco Central cut the interest rate by 50 basis points, again, to stimulate the economy, and we recognize the importance of that act. So for us, webinars is a way of engaging with government officials. It's a way of communicating our members your thoughts and also working together. Let me be very clear, the British Chamber, along with all the other chambers, has a clear commitment to the Philippine economy, Philippine workforce, and we want to work together and be part of that progression as we hopefully come out of this and work forward and the economy of everybody else.
Chris, just a final point, a check on the chamber. Just wanted to make sure that everyone's staying put. No one's deciding to leave the Philippines.
No, obviously we haven't had any feedback. We've actually even got some new members join during this time. What we're seeing from our members, and again, if I bring it back, what they'd like to see, of course, is a further reopening of the economy, and we're hopeful. Obviously, that depends obviously on health protocols, and obviously the moving forward, we'd like to see a modified general communicable quarantine. I think that's because obviously Metro Manila is a very key area. The other one is stimulus. We really would like to see a discussion of that, and we appreciate, you know, there is a request, I think your eyes towards 1.3 trillion, but I think stimulus, particularly for small to medium-sized enterprise, is very important. So the message so far to date, no, people are not leaving. In fact, what I'd like to give a slight encouragement is that we're actually getting inquiries and interest in the Philippines, and that's why I also brought up the point about people trying to visit, because currently, obviously, as you probably appreciate, our understanding is that's quite restricted in terms of foreign visitors. And that's important as well, because we're getting interest from business people about opportunities in the Philippines. So no is the answer, and we're still optimistic, and we'd like all to work together.
Just to follow up, Chris, what would be the implications for a reversion to the stricter enhanced community quarantine as infection curve continues to rise?
Well, if it's a move back, obviously, from a business point of view, that's going to be less activity. And we hope that won't occur on a generalized basis. As I mentioned to you, Kathy, and as I gave a specific example from the UK, particularly in Leicester, and I think that's also occurring in Spain, people are now much more focused on localized lockdowns, on specific areas, even on building sites or constructions or towns. I've even heard that in the Philippines. So we think that's the way forward. We have to keep the economy moving, because I think that's in the interests of everybody. Again, we fully understand and respect the health side of it, and that's what we communicate to our members. But I think that's the way forward. So it's got to be localized, specific, and how we can all work together collectively to get the economy moving and to help help employment, because that's a very specific concern of our members. And our members very much feel for their employees, and they want to see that work out.
Right. We hear you, Chris, all the way from London. You keep well where you are. Keep us up to speed on your travel plans. Chris Nelson of the British Chamber of Commerce Philippines, live from London.
Yeah. Thank you very much, Kathy. I say good morning to all your viewers. Apologies. my time zone gets a bit distorted, but I'd just like
no
to
worries.
Say...
It's just coming up to dawn there. I don't blame you. Thank you, Chris.
Thanks again. Have a great day, everybody. Bye-bye.